Devin. I am so pleased to have this gentleman join me this morning. I have missed talking to him so much. This is Dr. Ryan Jennings, Chief Medical Officer from St. Anthony Hospital. Good morning, Ryan. Oh, no, he can't hear me. Oh, my gosh.
Let's try this.
Are you there?
I'm here.
Okay, I'm sorry that the button looked like it was down, and it wasn't. So from this angle, it's kind of hard to see sometimes.
So I'm talking to nobody. That happens
yeah.
once in a while.
I do that a lot sometimes. Usually it's talking to my dog or fussing at my computer. It's what usually happens. So how are you, Ryan?
Well, I'm hanging in there, but boy, it's been a mighty busy time for everybody involved, you know, all across healthcare and really all across everything right now.
It's getting crazy again, isn't it? Or already is crazy again.
Yeah, unfortunately, you know, and maybe not terribly unexpectedly with, you know, summer winding down and folks getting out there and being around each other, we definitely have seen a significant surge in the amount of folks that, you know, have the disease and unfortunately even an uptick in the number of folks that are requiring hospitalization and, you know, just a lot more people with it. And, of course, there's always a certain percentage that are going to need a higher level of care.
Exactly. And I was reading some information on it actually earlier this morning and saw, not surprisingly, that the rate of the number of children that now have COVID has just risen dramatically, but they went back to school, many of them did. So that didn't surprise me. I hated to hear it, but it still didn't surprise me. And now a lot of them are going to full remote schools.
Yeah, I think we're going to probably hear a little more about that again. And gosh, without, you know, the homeschooling piece is certainly another taxing activity for our parents and things like that. But, you know, I'm looking at us coming into this holiday and really thinking about those kids. And, yeah, they've been in the schools. As we know, kids oftentimes are the asymptomatic carriers. They don't necessarily get really, really sick with it. But, you know, when they get around grandparents and loved ones and folks that are immune compromised, it can sure set us up for really harming, you know, someone we love potentially. So I think this is a year where thinking a lot about how we're going to celebrate our holidays and trying to be very careful, stay distanced if it's an option, and you know, try to really keep those of us that are, you know, somewhat impaired for whatever reason safe.
I totally agree, and this would, in theory, would have been perfect, but I just don't know too many people or families and friends that could pull it off. But I saw a little blurb last week that said, well, it was actually 2 weeks from Thanksgiving Day that I saw this, and it said that the safest way to have a get-together for Thanksgiving would be for every single person that is going to be there to quarantine for 2 weeks. Well, in theory, that would be perfect, but I just don't think it's very practical.
Yeah, no, there's that job thing that kind of
exactly.
messes with stuff. And, of course, again, the kids in schools, you know, a lot of my business meetings, you know, when there's somebody, a vendor or something that's wanting to talk, they're sending a meal to you via Grubhub, and then you do the meeting, you know, over electronically,
yeah.
but you're eating and enjoying yourself. And,
yeah.
you know, so maybe it's a year where you think about sending some Grubhub or whichever one of those DoorDash to your family member. And I'm sure it won't, well, it'll be as good as the turkey that I make, but it may not be as good as grandma's turkey. but it might be a way to stay safe. And of course, you know, the masking, the distancing, the hand washing. I usually at Thanksgiving, I'm talking about people getting their turkey to 165, and this year that's not the hot topic.
Right, exactly. that's so true. And I hope that people are, as we were talking about, that they're going to be restrained this year about getting everybody together, because I think what we all need to try to do, just my personal opinion, is look to the coming years where that we can, if we're careful this year, that hopefully by next year we will have, you know, we'll all be able to get together because we will have whipped this thing's butt.
Well, we know it worked. I mean, we know earlier, you know, when folks really were very, very concerned and did the masking and really curtailed going out and those types of things, that it flattened the curve. I mean, what we were hoping to do. But, you know, people are tired and tired of it, and so now we're seeing the uptick. But we also saw consequences, you know, when folks were, when we had to delay elective cases and those types of things. And that came with significant consequences. We saw, you know, and nationwide, we saw many folks that delayed care for heart attacks, strokes, those types of things. And that's devastating. So
yes,
although,
is.
You know, we want to caution people to try to stay in, certainly, you know, when there's something going on, you need to come to the emergency room if you're having those types of symptoms. And, you know, we're ready. The emergency departments are ready. And we've learned, I mean, the nice thing in the middle of all this, this kind of slowing down is you know, healthcare facilities learned how to continue to carry on the work of business, because there's still people having babies and there's still people that need emergency rooms and that kind of stuff. But at the same time, how do you care for folks coming in with COVID and separating people and doing those types of things safely? So, you know, healthcare is safe, and it's absolutely essential. And now we're just trying to figure out how do we continue to deliver on that when we're seeing a bigger surge than ever. So trying to decompress emergency rooms by using, you know, your phone number to your regular doctor for a little bit of advice. But of course, doing those things we talked about before around hand washing and masking and distancing. And the thing I've thrown in there is the flu shot now that we're coming into that time of year, because, you know, the last thing we need is a bunch more respiratory illness going around. And the only thing you need worse than that is COVID on top of flu.
Right.
And that won't be any fun for anybody, I'm positive. So
already,
so please do that.
Already weakened by the flu, and then to come down with that too, that would be a double whammy you don't want to experience.
No, it's devastating. But we are seeing some good stuff. You know, we're seeing effectiveness of remdesivir, and we've been very lucky. Production of remdesivir has remained really good, and hospitals have been well supplied. So we've got access to that. We've had time to ramp up production of personal protective equipment, and so more PPEs available. And we're seeing just smarter. We've gotten smarter about how we manage the disease. So some of all the conversation around ventilators and things like that, we've actually learned a lot about how to keep people from even going on the ventilator and finding that they do well. So we're starting to see mortality go down. We're seeing new drugs come onto the market. There's a new antibody, the one the president got, I believe, that bamlanivimab, hard to say it. I don't even know how to say it, but exciting because it's coming out. And then, of course, just within the last couple of days, we've seen great news around vaccines. And, you know, we're looking forward to those getting rolled out. Already conversations with public health systems about how we're going to do that. Of course, focusing on healthcare workers, frontline workers,
absolutely,
and first responders, because the impact on the workforce has been substantial as well. And, you know, that if there's a reason to wear a mask, if you don't want to wear a mask to protect yourself, boy, wear it to protect the ones you love and the healthcare workers, because they're we can't carry on without keeping our staff.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Now, back to, just because I hadn't heard of the one medication, I actually heard a story on the vaccine that came out 2 days ago or something like that. I can't remember the name of it. But the first medication you mentioned, I my ears couldn't even catch all that. It starts with an R, is that right?
Yeah, remdesivir. It's the one that, you know, kind of got us rolling to begin with. And that combined with some steroids seems to be effective, especially kind of just as folks start to need oxygen, start to get sick in the hospital type thing. So it's really for folks that are hospitalized. But really does seem to shorten their hospital stay and speed them to recovery. And like I said, we've been lucky to have good supplies of that. The new one, the bamlanivimab, that just rolled out, is really for folks that, you know, once it becomes in supply, will be for folks that don't necessarily need hospitalization but are at high risk.
Okay.
And so potentially help them to avoid hospitalization in its entirety. We're just now getting information on how that's going to be distributed, because, again, they're trying to send meds and supplies to places that need it most, rather than just leaving it to individual purchase. So so we're learning about that and excited to see that. And then, yeah, vaccines both seem to be highly effective, and hopeful that maybe by the end of next month, middle of next month, we'll start seeing that availability for healthcare workers. And then as we move into 2021, talking about vaccinating the public.
Oh, that would be fantastic. Make 2021 such a much better year than this last one that we've had, which has just been a nightmare.
Yeah, who would have thought in 10 months we'd still be dealing with it?
I know, exactly. Hey, I want to throw a shout out to some of your workers at St. Anthony. Since my illness started on July 17th when I broke my back, I've been admitted to St. Anthony's 3 times. And Ryan, I had such good care. I was so very impressed. And something else we were talking about, you know, the extra cleaning and everything that the hospitals and doctor's offices and clinics are doing. I'm here to tell you, the people that I saw cleaning, they were putting their heart and soul into it. They cleaned every spot in every room that I saw. I mean, I saw it. And the precautions that are being taken over there are amazing. So, job well done.
No, I appreciate that. And you bring up a great point, and that is, you know, we often think about the doctors and the nurses, but there's a whole team of people.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, even just the demands and the way we've had to manage food services and getting that type of thing, and the people in CAT scan and radiology and all those places that we now have had to learn about how to safely accomplish those tasks so that, you know, so that we can diagnose and treat somebody. So it's been a steep learning curve, but boy, the team has come together. And we've been talking a lot about the idea of, you know, in 20 years, when everybody's talking about, you know, when your kids are asking about the, what'd you do during the pandemic of 2020, you know, kind of your legacy of,
yeah,
of being able to say, well, you know, we really banded together and we did amazing things and saved lives,
yeah,
along the way.
Absolutely. Well, y'all have done an excellent job of that over there, Ryan. And I, for one, as a patient over there, evidently a repeat, I wanted to thank you guys.
Well, sometimes that happens, but that's why we're there. We want to be there to serve. And fortunately, you didn't deal with the COVID side of the world.
No,
but,
I didn't have to do
but
that.
We still got to take care of, you know, everything else. And that's what we're ready for.
Yeah. Well, there are some of us out there that really appreciate it. So good to talk to you again, Ryan. I do not like the circumstances, but I do like talking to you.
No, you're telling me. I the phone interview things are, you know, they're fun. I've got my rolling studio. I do this from the truck because it's quiet.
Uh-huh, right. Yeah. Well, you take care and stay safe.
You too. Thanks, Gail.
Uh-huh. Thank you, Ryan.
Bye-bye.
Bye.